Before I graduated, he was Mr. Harris to me. I first met him in 1983. He was a choir teacher at that time. And he saw something in me that I didn't even know existed. Anyway, he became very close to me and my family. And he was my father. He was my father. Rich is the reason why I sing. Rich is the reason why I am who I am. When he moved to Albuquerque just after he retired, he left me his turntable, and I found he was just sneaking things to me, you know. Here, Dave, take this, take this. I'm like, Rich, I really don't need that, you know. Thanks, but, you know, I'll take it. So, that's how he was. And in fact, a couple of Christmases ago, we were in Ralph's, not too far from his place. And he was just looking around the store. And I was like, what's going on, man? He goes, just look at these people. Nobody smiled. I'm like, oh, what is he going to do? So, guess what he did? He started singing a Christmas jingle in the middle of the store. Of course, I was like, yeah, that's who he was. You know, he loved to help, he loved to smile, he loved to encourage. When I was looking through the, you know, he liked to put things in plastic bags for me. The turntable and like the little cleaner that it came with. I just 3 days ago opened the plastic bag just to look at the stuff, just so I could feel close to him. And any and everything that he had given me, I was, you know, looking at. And I came across a note that I never knew was in that bag. Of course, I saw the note and it said, my son on the cover. And I was reading it to my wife, and she started crying, and I brought it, and this is what it said. I didn't know that it was in there. I just found this 3 days ago. So it said, dear Gabriel, though 1,000 miles soon shall be between us, know this. My deep love and respect for you is sent from God, and his blessings prove that your home is heaven. If there is one most important thing that I daily strive to write upon your heart is this: your life matters to our world and to our God's word. Depend upon it. My eternal love, Father Rich. Now, I read this just 3 days ago. He didn't tell me that it was in here. Anyway, I love you, Rich. To those given, much is required. That's what he would always say to me. And one last thing I want to say before I go back to sit down is that he wrote a song. He wrote several songs, but this one song in particular he wrote for me. It's called "Your Smile Is Still the One," and I'll just sing a couple of bars. True love never dies. It never leaves the eyes of those who really care. Don't fear what time may bring. It cannot change a thing. your smile that scared the one. I love you, Rich. Thank you.
Any place in the world better than here. He loved coming every day. Richard had a combination of things that are very important to an unusual human being. He was very passionate. Passion is not sufficient, because even suicide bombers are passionate. Destructive people are passionate. I don't think they're passionate. But Richard had passion along with compassion. He cared about them so much, and his passion and his compassion were equal. He really cared about people. He didn't mean anybody that he didn't like. And I'm telling you, I don't know anybody that didn't like Richard. I think I have a lot of passion and compassion. But I made some enemies in my life, and I'm glad I did. I don't like them. Margarita was saying that, Herbert Jones was saying that. Sometimes they had students that couldn't stand me, especially when I called them up the auditorium running their mouths. Come on down. Come on down. I can't stand you. You love me now, but back then, you know. Because when you're a teenager, somebody's got to give instruction. Good cause. The more instruction you give children when they're young, the more freedom they have later. The less instruction you give them, the more instruction they have later. It's called confinement. It's called lack of opportunity. You can't even leave the corner, leave your block. You have a number of relationships. Richard saved a lot of students. We have a lot of statistics on students that went astray. We have a lot of statistics on who dropped out, who went to prison, who died. We don't have a lot of statistics on who we saved, because that's not a statistic. We have a statistic on the negative. I often say it was an interesting thing that a movie was made out of school, because it works. Movies and things that the media pays attention to are kind of interesting, because the media only pays attention to unusual circumstances. They don't take pictures of good weather, airplanes that land safely. They take pictures of tsunamis, crashes, unexpected events. So when a school works, why was it unexpected? Why did a movie need to be made out of a school? Because it works. It was supposed to work. But because it wasn't and hadn't, people had become so accustomed that they were shocked when it began to work. Because in our community, what do we expect? What do others expect? What do we expect of ourselves? Some of us were getting on buses, couldn't wait to go somewhere, thinking they were running away from themselves. And so Richard said, here, you build. And I believed in him and he believed in me. This music program is very important. We had just a small band at the time. We had Richard with the choral music. And the band was so small, we only had like 11 people. And 9 of them had horns and a few drummers. And a little pop line. A little pop line. That's all we had. I remember we went to Banning High School. Banning filled up the field from the 5-yard line to the 5-yard line. They had flex barriers, they had pants, they had all kinds of bands. They had 120 people in it. We come out there with less than 20 people. A little pop line. Yeah. And we went to Banning. Myself, that'll never happen again. So I start working on getting myself a band.